In November 1985, 7:48 and 6:56 hauled a special freight train from Whangarei to Opua and back. We joined them north of Whangarei in a heavy downpour. A month later, the Railway Enthusiasts Society ran an excursion on the same line, this time with two fruit salad BAs, 512 and 633. Again, we catch up with the train just north of Whangarei. The Sunset Coast Express took fans to the opening of the Waiuku extension of the Glenbrook Vintage Railway in December 86. DA-529 turned the 20-car train at Glenbrook and gave moral support to JA-1250 throughout the return journey. The last regular assignments for DAs were the two overnight trains each way between Auckland and Whangarei, daily trains out of Whangarei to the north, and local shunts in the Auckland area. On the second last day of August, number 656 was in charge of 19 shunt to Helensville. After switching cars at the Caxton Printing Works in Henderson, 19 heads north. Containers of processed kiwi fruit from the Bay of Plenty are exchanged for empties at the Kaipara Dairy Factory. The Helensville Loop was out of service due to a derailment earlier in August. To run around the train, the crew had to use the triangle before returning to Auckland. Thank you. will remain with us for several more years. Between 1978 and 1983, more than half were remanufactured in Australia by Clyde Engineering into DC class units. A new V12 engine of 645 cubic inch per cylinder displacement was installed, increasing the continuous output of the units to 1,500 horsepower. The rebuilding included a new short hood and cab and repositioning of the dynamic brakes to behind the cab. Several other DAs have been set aside for preservation by rail fan groups. These units will probably be restored to as-built appearance. Others weren't quite as lucky. Many were withdrawn after major component failures or derailments. Even minor accidents could result in an early retirement. One such incident occurred at Kumiu, when number 656 snagged its cowcatcher and screeched to a halt in front of the station. After a quick amputation of the offending piece of metal, the DA was able to limp back to Auckland to an uncertain future. Whether you remember them on the main trunk line, on excursion trains, or working city industries, the DAs have earned the respect of both their crews and rail fans, in much the same way as the AB and K's had. The General Motors G12 has proved a tough act to follow.